At Sly Media Productions, we offer live streaming services to companies willing to reach a worldwide audience. We have the capacity to live stream debates from various locations for a wide range of clients.
And our online audience, we welcome you back.
We follow them and help build Zimbabwe brand on a positive note.
On the second report on citizens' perceptions.
And for us, our interest has always been around how do we leverage technology to communicate policy, to communicate public issues.
No.
Let me tell you what is the problem. The problem is the unbridled ambition by Umonzo. If I was him or his team, I wouldn't even pursue this nonsense thing, taking it to the media. Hey, Mozora held spoken by a caller. Do you even think that's possible? Obvious when I can't you see what that's their campaign. They are trying to create this picture that they are invincible, they are in charge. So it's just some useless narrative which will then force me. They know what I will not comment against the standing committee Google Media. But what that then does is, the more they push this narrative, I will now have to tell the side, my side of the story, or rather the accurate side of the story, what happened. What happened today, Chairman, Ogani, and now Mfundo, we sat in that meeting. I then spoke of violence. I did not mention anyone there, but I think everyone knows who is behind the violence. I then told them, these boys are going to miscalculate, you know, and they're going to touch someone like myself. And the person behind them will regret the day he was born, you know. And I just told them that it's disgusting that we're sitting here every day. I have to answer to the media about violence that is sponsored by leadership because you're desperate for a position, right? So that was that. And then no one challenged me that report was accepted. So then later, a major had to report Giles on the issue of staff campaigning. So the previous standing committee, he was given a task to investigate that tribal tirade by that boy. When he was reporting, I think he didn't get that brief, so he left that thing out. You see, I then challenged Uguti, but this is a whitewash, Musa. First of all, the minutes did not even speak about the issue. It just glossed over it as if, and I've spoken strongly about that issue, that as a party, we cannot tolerate tribalists amongst us. So it turns out that Major did not hear the brief. And then, Umonzora then wanted to downplay that thing, to say, it's a small thing that the standing committee can't deal with. It is at that point, I actually didn't call him a dictator. I actually called him a disgusting bigot. That's what I called him. Told him that he's a coward. He is mobilizing youth, feeding them. And now you have taught who was beaten, he had to go to hospital, and I have to face the media daily and defend that, because he's a coward. And then Chief also came in. Chief told him that was Joela Gabiwe, you know. And then it was clear Uguti, had it not been of Madam President, I mean, the whole thing was degenerating, so Madam President said, no, guys, cool down. So we told him that you mobilize people to abuse us tribally, and you come and sit here. You are not even fit to be, no, that I did say, is not even fit to be a chairperson of a parent society. So it's not in his interest to be pushing this thing, because I'll now be forced to come public and say what happened. I mean, you guys, you can call any of those standing committee members. They'll tell you he had no one supporting him. He was isolated. He was isolated. So I'm not surprised. You see, today he's coming up with this thing of saying that war in Matabele land. You can't be surprised when a guy has people who saying Ndebele is a jokes in his campaign. In the same campaign, you have someone saying two angry Ndebeles. I don't know who he was referring to. Remain just two votes. I mean, such blatant tribalism, and you have the guards to sit in a standing committee and try and defend that. You see, so that is what happened. He can't touch me. He can't, there's no way to, he helped me by the collar. Do you think that is possible? I am sorry, Belamina. No, No. I needed to tell him the facts, and I wanted him to know. I did tell him that I'm not scared of him. Not only him, I'm not scared of those boys that is mobilizing. I told him, and I'm being honest, one of those boys is going to miscalculate and touch me or touch Chief or he's playing with fire, and I don't think he knows.
I think it's intimidation, cause fear, so that can go and challenge or whatever. So in the Wayama report, there was not one that started.
No, the recalls, look, I mean, remember they started that tribal thing which they pushed to say Madam President is putting her friends. The recalls, remember the National Council of the 9th of May. You guys actually recommended that we recall everyone in PR and the Senate. That's what you guys recommended. And we did give him the names that are supposed to be recalled. Some of them he changed unilaterally. When it comes to Madam President, Madam President was not involved in the issue. I'm not lying. I mean, I've got letters from different provinces. They wrote to the standing committee and recommended that people be removed, and people were removed. When it comes to filling up of those places, those opened by the recalls, it was Chairman Komich and Madam Chair Konye. They were the ones who were responsible for this process. They actually consulted the provinces. And the provinces then gave them the names to replace. I also have letters to that effect. But we excluded him. That's why this process went smoothly. We excluded him. We excluded him. It's the chairman who signed. It's Deputy S. Jim Porina who countersigned. And this process went this smooth because we excluded him. There is no process with him that has gone anywhere smooth or this smooth. Without him, the processes go smooth. So he wanted to create some scandal, which is definitely not there. And we did tell him that in the standing committee. I personally did tell him that.
Well,
I don't know. He is exaggerating it, or let me say to his campaign is exaggerating it in the media. But Madam President, he said in that same meeting, no, you guys are cool down, so we cool down. I don't have a personal problem with him, by the way, but I want to tell you this, Chairman. Look, I see myself leading this party one day. But even beyond the party, I have a country to build, and this country, I'm building it through this party. To allow one person, because of his ambitions, to destroy all of this. So many lives died for this party. So many lives suffered for this part. So you can't just allow one person because of his ambitions to bring down this whole thing. So that is where I'm coming from. As a person, I have no problems with him. You remember the interviews I was doing when I was in South Africa, and I said, Dr. Kupe, Dr. Monzora, that's one, to me, really, there's no difference. If any one of them prevails, I really meant it. But I can tell you now, what, you know, God forbid, if it turns out to be him, and at the rate he's going, and I can tell you now, you have no party. That's number one. Number two, I can tell you in a general election, he can't beat Dr. Nkosana Moyo. He can't. If he goes beyond 15,000, you'll be lucky. You just look at the tribal campaign he's running. Hey, Karanga's this. Hey, Debele's this. Hey, this and that. Really? I mean, you, in one person, you have a campaign that says Ndebeles are dogs. In one person, you have a campaign that says two angry Ndebeles. In one person, now Kukrawundi was a, what do you call this, was a civil war. That's one person, eh? That's one person. Now, the Chimanikire there, you don't find all these tribal territories, right? You have a senator committee. You have Senator Komich, you don't find this. You have Senator Mutsuri, you don't find all of this. All these people are candidates. You have Dr. Kupe, you don't find this. In one person. In one person.
So in your opinion, Spokes, what is the solution and the way forward? Because we can't keep having this negative media attention while we're working towards looking at the facts. Because that's what our enemies want to see. They want to see us fail. So what is the way forward and what's the solution? Because we need one, and we need to be proactive and act soon.
Well, good question, Chair. You see, the problem with this position that I have is that it also captures me. You see, so I'm not able to be as forthcoming as I could possibly be when I didn't have this position, because then I'll be accused of playing for one audience or for the audience of one, and not really speaking for the whole party. You know, so it's you now. The duty is upon you guys to then stand up for the values and the principles of the party. You see, let me give an example. You will see what I said to the journalist when the journalist asked me. I said I would not comment because I couldn't also reject that there was a fracas, because if I had rejected, then I would have been lying and I would have felt bad about it, because I've made a commitment anyway that I'm not going to lie. Plus, at the same time, I have a duty towards the party not to air our dirty laundry in public. You understand? But I can tell you now, from where I'm standing or where I'm seated right now, I meant what I said. The guy does not qualify to lead even a better society.
At Sly Media Productions, we offer live streaming services to companies willing to reach a worldwide audience. We have the capacity to live stream debates from various locations for a wide range of clients.
And our online audience, we welcome you back.
We follow them and help build Zimbabwe brand on a positive note.
On the second report on citizens' perceptions.
And for us, our interest has always been around how do we leverage technology to communicate policy, to communicate public issues.